guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm your girl EISHATAYLORE. So as you can see by the title, yes, I dyed my hair. I bleached my hair. So honestly, Instagram was the first to know. So if you're not following me on Instagram, then you're kind of missing out on a lot of like real up-to-date things in my life. So go ahead and follow your girl. So yes, I got my hair colored and everything. And on my Instagram, I asked if anyone had any questions regarding the fact that I dyed my hair. And also, this is technically, quote unquote, a collab too with Roger Dwayne here on YouTube. He also dyed his hair as well. His video won't be out the same time as mine. However, we did kind of come together with questions that was on his community tab here on YouTube and my questions from Instagram and kind of merged it together. So the first question is, did you have to bleach your hair? Yes, I did. So I'm gonna just insert a couple like clips and videos. I didn't go into the salon with the mindset of vlogging or recording the process just because not everyone likes to have a camera in their face like that or to see their process. So I decided not to do that. But yes, I did have to bleach my hair. So it's only in the front. So if I literally lift up my hair right here, the sides are still black. So if I kind of hide this, my hair's still black. It's the front that is colored. And that's kind of what I want. This is like a perm rod set fail, but it's okay. It's still cute though. So I wanted it to look like that because I didn't want my whole head to be that color. I have naturally like 1B black hair. So I didn't want to kind of lose that. I have colored my hair before in the past and I instantly missed my black hair. So I was like, you know what? Let's do half and half. Let's like do the colors to frame my face. And I think this actually came out really, really good. Y'all can see it kind of looks like highlights in this style, but you know, we'll see how it looks curly. All right, second question, why didn't you do your whole head and just the front? Yeah, the people that saw it on Instagram, they did see the fact that I didn't do the whole head. Kind of just answered that because I want to keep my true black hair in the back and to add some dimension, because I feel like my hair is already so fine and thin, like, you know, thinner density, that I feel like adding two different colors will kind of add dimension and make it look thicker. Maybe that's just my head. I don't know. Did you do it yourself? No, baby girl. I surely did not. I was not going to color my hair myself. I have in the past, but I knew this time going in, I didn't feel like doing it myself. Those type of dyes are just not the best. So I knew I wanted to go to professional and have them handle the process. And plus, the way that I wanted this done is not just the front, because as you can see, I still have my black hair in here. Can y'all see? I still have my black hair in here. So I knew that if I did it myself, I wouldn't really know how to do it. So I just left it to the professionals, child. Is it box dye? I just said it. No, it's not box dye. I just wasn't trying to mess with that. And there's nothing against people that do it. I just knew that I couldn't do that and figure it out, so I chose not to. All right, next question. What are you going to do differently now that your hair is dyed? That's a great question. A lot is going to change most naturally because now I have to look at whether or not the products are color treated safe, because there are some like natural hair products that can either fade my color faster. What I already know I'm gonna be doing differently is definitely less conventional shampoos, for sure, because I don't want this color to strip. My moisturizing routine is gonna change because naturally my hair is going to be drier now. So, you know, definitely sealing my hair more often. I might even incorporate the LCL or the LOC method and see which one works for me. Are there any products you have to, see, I'm answering these questions without even realizing. Are there any products you have in your stash you have to avoid now? Yes, I basically said that. I think I have to be careful with henna. So I have to look and see any curls and potion products that may have henna in it because it might turn this color a different color I don't want, you know? So I just have to look into that. But other than that, it's honestly not much is going to change. Per se, I'm still avoiding, you know, the regular no parabens, no sulfates, things like that that strip my hair, no alcohols, child, no alcohols for sure. What will change in your regimen? Is this the same questions? I guess kind of ish. So my regimen is going to change a little bit. I will be incorporating more protein treatments, of course, because that's necessary. So I did a review on the Curl Junkie Repair Me Reconstructive Hair Treatment. So I have to probably incorporate this at least once a month at this point. I'm definitely going to be incorporating a lot more of my Olaplex treatments. If you haven't seen my shorts, I hate this name, short. Is it short? Shorts? Either way, it's stupid. The YouTube version of Reels and TikToks here on YouTube. The shorts, I did one for Olaplex. I got the rest of the line. So I have a big number 3 now. And then I now have the shampoo and the conditioner. Oh, let me show y'all the difference. This is the small number 3. This is the big number 3. Just so y'all can see. So I have the shampoo and the conditioner, which again, I featured in that video. I've already used these and I absolutely love these. Even though these are small, this is going to last me an extremely, extremely long time. Especially the shampoo, because a little bit goes a long way. This has lather for days. And then they have number 8, which is a Bond Intense Moisture Mask. This is absolutely amazing. This is amazing. So this is definitely going to be a difference in my regimen. I'm going to be trying less deep conditioners here on my channel, unless it's for color treated hair, because I want to make sure I'm getting in all the nutrients from Olaplex to keep this color alive and to keep my hair from being damaged and dry. Something else that's changing is a couple of my products. I picked up the Adra Beauty Blue Tansy collection, even though I said I wasn't going to. Once I got color treated, I was like, I might as well buy it. And then it was a Sephora sale, so I was like, double and I picked it up. So I have the shampoo, which is somewhere, the leave-in conditioner, the deep conditioner. I've skipped the whole conditioner, and I have the serum as well, which I used on my hair today. So tried the leave-in conditioner. I love it. Super creamy, very moisturizing, and I can tell that my hair soaks it up a lot. So you'll be seeing this a lot more on my channel. And this Blue Tansy Reparative Mask. I know y'all probably seen tons of reviews on it, but for color treated hair specifically, since it does say for color treated hair on here, this stuff is amazing. So I said all of that to say that I'm going to be deep conditioning a lot more. I'm going to be doing more protein treatments, more Olaplex treatments, and sealing my hair for sure. How do you avoid damage from dyeing your hair? I mean, how do you avoid? So, okay, two things. So you have to also make sure your hair is in a good state. So with this particular salon that I went to, they did a hair consultation before I even dyed my hair to assess to see if my hair is ready and healthy for dye. Okay, that's the first thing. Make sure that your salon and stylist kind of knows your hair and assesses the health of your hair. But two, before I even came to her, I did an Olaplex treatment too. I was like, we're doing an Olaplex treatment. I actually had this deep conditioner on hand too. I did this deep conditioner and I just got my hair like super ready for, because I knew I was bleaching my hair. So I kind of got it ready for that. So I would say to avoid damage is to kind of have a good regimen in place, have some good products in place, get your hands on Olaplex if you're thinking of getting your hair colored, and then continuing that after your color, because I mean, that's the whole point. There's no way to avoid damage, because when you are breaking down your hair and cuticle shaft, I don't know the science of it, when you're breaking down your hair, there is a risk for damage. So there's no way to completely avoid damage, but to prevent it from being worse than what it could be is Olaplex and protein treatments and things like that. And just like really making sure you're not a lazy natural, because you can't be lazy when you have color treated hair. Why did you decide to dye your hair? Great question. I don't know. I'm just getting tired of my black hair all around, and I feel like I wasn't looking any different from any other person with black hair. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just wanted to separate myself from other people, and I've been wanting color for a long, long time, and I feel like this color really complements my skin tone. And even like when it gets in the summertime, I'm gonna add more blonde highlights. I think it's gonna be gorgeous. Do you think your porosity changed? I'm pretty sure it changed. When you break down again, that hair layer your porosity most likely will change. So this is probably high porosity now, most likely. But again, I'm still gonna be marketing myself as low porosity because my hair, it's more hair that's not dyed than it is dyed. So, you know, it just looks like it's a lot in the front, but it's really not that much. Do you have to do protein treatments more often with color treated hair? Yes, I basically said this already. Yes, you do. How much drier do your ends get now as opposed to uncolored hair? I can already tell it's a lot drier and it will look drier too, just off rip, but you can tell like right here. Like it just looks drier. I mean, this will vary everyone's hair because my hair before it was dyed was naturally dry. So I mean, it's just more dry. I don't really know how to really answer that question because it's drier than my untouched hair, my uncolored hair. You just have to moisturize it. I don't know. Like, I don't really know how to really answer that per se, but have you noticed a difference in moisture retention, curl pattern, or porosity? My curls are still here. So my curl pattern didn't change. The front of my hair has always been looser. So I mean, that's that. My porosity, I'm pretty sure changed slightly. I'm still gonna be treating it as if it's low porosity hair and just like moisturizing it, deep conditioning with heat, using heat in general, etc., etc. So I'm not too sure if it changed too much, but that's that. And moisture retention, naturally the front of my hair is drier anyway, so I used to cater to the front of my hair differently than the rest of my hair, so I'm going to continue doing that same exact thing. Is it drier? Yes. So I just have to apply a lot more product to the front, but other than that, it's still taking in moisture the same. So far, I haven't had any issues. So that's that. And the last question that I have on here is, I'm scared to death to color. I never did. So how do you feel about the maintenance? I don't feel no way about it because I feel like healthy hair, I still have to do these things. Olaplex is amazing. So I'm excited to use Olaplex all the damn time. I mean, whatever. The Adra Beauty products I love so far. My maintenance is not going to change per se. I think the maintenance that's going to be annoying to me and the most costly is to upkeep the color, if anything, because then once it fades, then you're gonna have to, you know, retouch it and whatever. I'm not excited for that. If you have any other questions though, leave them down below. So now I am a color treated natural, I guess. So I will catch you guys in the next one. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Bye guys.